Today we are talking about this, the Sony HDR-CX625. This is the camera that I bought in December. I've been using it now for 1 month. So I want to talk to you about the things I like and I don't like so much. I have to say that I'm satisfied about the camera. The price was 480 euro. The list price of the camera on the website of Sony is 550 euro. But I think that you can find it in retail shops for a bit less. I will start by mentioning the things that I don't like so much on the camera. The first is that the lens has not a glass cover. You see that there is a cover which opens and closes, but beside that there is nothing else. So a lot of dust can go on the lens but also inside the camera. That's why I bought this small UV lens. It costs something like 20 euro. You can screw it in front of the lens like that, so to seal the camera and the lens from dust. This is an aftermarket lens from Hama. 46 millimeter will do the job. I would recommend to buy a filter the same at the same moment you buy the camera. When you unpack it, you can immediately put it on, so no dust will go in. Something that I'm not very keen of is the fact that the camera makes a lot of folders on the card. That means that if you want to transfer your videos from the camera to the computer, you need to click 4 folders deep, which in my opinion is a bit too much. I don't see the necessity. Something else that I'm not very keen of is that all the settings are to be changed on the screen. The camera has a touch screen. That means that when you are filming, if you want to change the exposure to make the image a bit darker or lighter, you have to use the touch screen. So you have to go in the menu to switch off the automatic exposure and then push a lot of times the plus or minus button. Also, this menu covers a large piece of the image you are filming, so you don't know exactly what you are doing. One of the features that I like a lot is that the camera has its own USB cable on it. As you see, it's part of the camera. That means that you have always your USB cable with you to plug it to the computer to transfer the videos to the computer, so you don't have to take extra cables with you and you don't even forget them when you are traveling. You can use this USB cable also to charge the camera. In the box you have an extension cord which looks like that. This part goes in the camera and this goes to the charger, which is a plug-in. Nice thing is that you can use also a usual telephone charger to charge your camera, or as I do, a dual charger, which is an aftermarket one which I bought some time ago. It is 2.1 amps, so it's enough to charge the camera and the phone simultaneously. You cannot use the charging via USB while filming. But the good thing is that the camera has also a DC in slot, so you can use an external power plug to charge the camera or take the battery off and use the camera to film while powered up. The power plug is not in the box when you buy the camera, but you can buy it extra. Other good thing is that the camera displays always how much time you have left on the battery, so you always know how much time you can record. Of course, a big advantage of this camera is its stabilization, which is really impressive. I will make a short video to show you that. To do that, I will put a little bit of tape, you can see it, a little bit of tape on the lens, like that. And now I'm going to make a black dot on the tape and I'm going to film a bit so you can see the difference between the image and the shaking of the camera. Now let's talk about Play Memories Mobile, which is the application you can download and install on your phone. The application is available for Android and for iPhone. Nice is that the camera has a QR code, which you can use to download the application directly. And then it uses Wi-Fi to connect directly with the phone and not via an other network. I use it when I use the camera in my workshop. In that case, it's not very easy to reach the camera, so I use the phone to control it. You can zoom in, zoom out, and start and stop the recording, which is pretty much enough. You can also use the application to transfer the files from the camera to the phone and then upload images or videos to YouTube, Facebook or Instagram without using a computer. So you can do that when you are outdoors. The last feature I want to talk about, which I use often, is the time-lapse function. When using the time-lapse, the camera makes one picture every couple of seconds. You can set the shooting interval to 1, 2, 5, 10, 30 or 60 seconds and the shot number from 1 until 999. I use that to make short animations. I put it mostly on 5 second shooting interval, which are enough for me to move the objects that I'm photographing. Overall, I have to say that the Sony HDR CX 625 is a good purchase. I think that it is a good value for money camera. There are some little things that I don't like so much, but I think that for that price you cannot get better. So that's it for today. I am going to use this camera a lot. Give it a thumbs up if you liked it, and I will see you next time. Bye bye.